Hello dear students, welcome back in our biology session. I hope that you all have enjoyed your Diwali vacation. Okay, so now the vacation is over. Now let's move for the study. So today during this biology session, we are going to start our new lesson and the name of the lesson is Respiration in Animals. Okay, so in this lesson we are going to see what is meant by the respiration, which are the different organs are there which helps to do the respiration, and so many things we are going to discuss which are related to the respiration in this lesson. What is the name of the lesson? That is Respiration in Animals. Okay, so before going to start the lesson, let's discuss about some things, or let's discuss about one story, we can say that. So you have ever think that whenever you are walking or whenever you are running so fast for a long time, then what happens? You are started to do the breathing very fastly. Okay, so why it happens, why we are started to do the breathing very fastly? Okay, so that is the reason the breathing and the respiration is somehow related to each other. Okay, but it is very important to keep in the mind is that the breathing is different while the respiration is also different. Okay, so we are continuously doing the respiration. Why? Because the respiration gives us energy. But how the respiration gives us energy, that we are going to see in this, the first point, and the name of our point is what? Why do we respire? Okay, why we are doing the respiration process, why it is necessary to do the respiration process. Okay, so in our some previous lesson, or in our lesson number 2, we have discussed that all the organisms are made up of a single, all the organisms are made up of a very tiny, or the body of a living organisms are made up of what? Cells. What is mean by the cells? It is the structural and functional unit of a living organisms. Okay, so in this way what we can say that all the living organisms are made up of cells, and each and every cells are having the different functions. The cells are performing the digestion, respiration, reproduction, excretion. So all these are the systems present in our body, and all these systems are doing their work continuously or properly with the help of these different cells. Okay, so different cells are performing the different functions. Whenever we are sleeping, whenever sleeping quietly, then also these cells are doing their functions. Means the cells are doing the functions throughout their life. They are not taking rest at all. Okay, but to perform any function, to perform any work, obviously we requires the energy. Like that, the cells also requires the energy to perform their functions. Okay, but the question is that from where they are getting that energy, from where the cell is getting the energy to perform their work? Yes, so the answer for this question is that the cell is getting the energy to perform their work from the food that we are eating. Okay, so from the food the cell is getting the energy. But how? Because how that we are going to see in these upcoming sessions. Okay, and that is the reason that our parents, our adults persons are telling us that you have to eat properly, or we have to eat regularly. Why? Because from the food we are getting the energy, and that energy is get utilized by the different cells to perform their different work. Okay, so whenever we are doing the respiration, what we are doing? We are taking the air which is rich in oxygen, and at the other hand, whenever we are throwing out the air, that air is what? Rich in carbon dioxide. Okay, so we inhale the air, that air is rich in oxygen, while we exhale the air, that air is rich in carbon dioxide. Okay, up till here clear? Next one. So the air which we inhale, that air is rich in what? Oxygen. That air is rich in what? Oxygen. So this oxygen get entered into our body, and alternately it get provided, that oxygen reach to the different cells also. Okay, So once the oxygen enter in our body, that oxygen is get transported to the different body parts. From the different body parts, it get transported to the each and every cell which are present in our body. And that oxygen is used to break down the food that we have eaten, okay? So the oxygen is used in the breakdown of the food, and when there is a breakdown of the food, then it release the energy, okay? Then it release the energy. And where all these processes happen? That all the processes happens into the cell, okay? So in the cell, the oxygen is get utilized to break down the food and to release the energy, and that respiration is called as what? Cellular respiration, okay? That respiration is called as what? Cellular respiration. Respiration is nothing but what? The breakdown of the food and to release the energy. That process is called as what? Respiration, okay? So in the cell, the respiration is happens, that's why it is called as what? Cellular respiration. What happens in the respiration? The oxygen is get utilized. With the help of the oxygen, the food can get breakdown and then release the energy, and that process is called as what? Respiration. But in the human body, where this processes happens? This processes happens in the cell, and that's why it is called as what? Cellular respiration, okay? So we can say the definition of the cellular respiration is what? The process of respiration takes place in the cell with the help of the oxygen to break down the food and to release the energy. Then that respiration is called as what? Cellular respiration. And the cellular respiration is takes place in all the living organisms, okay? Up till here we have discussed about the respiration and cellular respiration. And in here you have understood that why we have to eat the food, and how from the food how we are getting the energy. Because from the food, that food we are having, that food get break down with the help of the oxygen, and then it release the energy. That's why we have to eat the food also, and we have to do the continuously breathing also. And from this both the process we can get the energy with the help of this respiration process. In some animals, or in the animals, the breakdown of the food is takes place in the presence of oxygen, okay? So the breakdown of the food takes place in the presence of oxygen, then that process is called as what? Aerobic respiration. Then that respiration is called as what? Aerobic respiration, okay? So what is mean by the aerobic respiration? The breakdown of the food takes place in the presence of oxygen, then that respiration is called as what? Aerobic respiration, okay? So here we are having the equation for the aerobic respiration. What is that equation? See, glucose. Glucose means what? Whatever the food we are having, that is the one form of glucose. So this glucose get break down in the presence of oxygen. Very important thing, student, keep in the mind what? The food get break down in the presence of oxygen, and then it release what? Carbon dioxide, water and energy. Then that process is called as what? Aerobic respiration, okay? So the aerobic respiration requires the oxygen for the breakdown of the food. Next one, in some animals, the respiration is takes place, or the breakdown of the food is happens in the absence of oxygen. Without use of oxygen, then that process of respiration is called as what? Anaerobic respiration, okay? The word anaerobic respiration. So what is mean by the anaerobic respiration? The breakdown of the food happens in the absence of oxygen, then that respiration is called as anaerobic respiration, okay? So here we are again having one equation for the anaerobic respiration, that is nothing but what? Glucose. Glucose means what? The food we are having, that is the one form of glucose. That glucose get break down without use of oxygen, and then release alcohol, carbon dioxide and energy, okay? So this is the equation for the anaerobic respiration and this is the equation for the aerobic respiration. The key words that you have to keep in your mind, that is what? The aerobic respiration takes place in the presence of oxygen, while anaerobic respiration takes place in the absence of oxygen. Okay. Next one, the organisms, those who are showing the anaerobic respiration, that organisms are called as what? Anaerobes. Okay, that organisms are called as anaerobes. Okay, for that anaerobes we can take one example, that is what? Yeast. That is nothing but the yeast is a two types. Some yeast are the single cell and yeast. So yeast is a single celled organism, those who are showing the anaerobic respiration, and while performing that anaerobic respiration release the alcohol, and that is the reason that yeast is used in the beer and in the wine industries, okay, for the production of the alcohol with the help of the anaerobic respiration. So this anaerobic respiration is sometimes shown by our muscle cells also, okay, when, but only for the short period of the time. But when our muscles are doing the anaerobic respiration, when we are doing the very high physical activity for the long period of the time, suppose we can say we are running, we are walking, we are cycling, we are jumping, means what? So much work we are doing for the long period of the time, that what, that time what happened? Our body requires the more amount of the energy, okay. So we require the more amount of the energy, but what happened? The oxygen that requires for the breakdown of the food and to release the energy, that amount of the oxygen is less. So our body cannot fulfill the need of the more amount of the energy, okay. So whenever we are performing the heavy exercise, our body requires the more amount of the energy, but that much energy our body cannot provide to us, and that is the reason sometime our muscles started to do the anaerobic respiration for the short period of the time, okay. So that anaerobic respiration which takes place in the muscles, that process is again having the one equation, we can say that what? Glucose, it happens in the absence of oxygen, okay, it happens in the absence of oxygen, we can write here without use of oxygen, and then it releases lactic acid and also it releases the energy, okay, also it releases the energy, okay. So see here, this is the equation for the anaerobic respiration which is performed by our muscle cells, okay, and the muscle cells are also doing the anaerobic respiration for the some time, for the short time, when our body requires the more amount of the energy.
Area, the circulation will get increased and there is a more amount of the oxygen will get provided to that particular body part or that particular muscle. And that increased amount of the oxygen is helps to break down this lactic acid into carbon dioxide and water. Okay, so because of the massage, what happens? The circulation will increase, and then because of the circulation, the oxygen will also get increased, and that increased amount of the oxygen will get utilized to break down this lactic acid into carbon dioxide and H2O. Okay, so in this way we are getting the relief from the muscle cramp. Okay, so this is all about today. Today we have discussed about the why do we respire. In that we have discussed about the cellular respiration. Also we have discussed about the aerobic and anaerobic respiration. Anaerobic respiration also takes place in our muscles, and how we are getting that muscle cramps and how we are getting the relief from that person. That all the things we have discussed today. Okay, so this is all about today. Today we will stop here. This is the time to tell you goodbye. We'll meet in the next video with the next point, and for today